Back at Quicken Loans Arena, Aaron Goldhammer and Jordan Sherwood with you. 6:59 to go first half. And Ohio with a 25-15, surprising. The number 9 seed with a 10-point lead on the number 1 seed here at the Q. Jordan, one of the areas that Ohio right now is dominating is on the glass.
Oh, certainly. Out-rebounding the Kent State Golden Flashes are the Bobcats, 17-10. And a lot of it has to do with the gang rebounding that Ohio U is doing. It's not really one guy getting taking control of the glass. It's a multitude of guys on this roster that are doing their job. Reggie Keeley with a nice offensive putback that last possession. He's got a couple 3 rebounds. So does Kenneth Van Kempen. So if you continue to do that, Kent State shoots about poorly, 28% so far in the game. That's going to result in a win for Ohio U.
Now Ohio's 5 of 9 from 3-point range as well. Freeman kicking the inbound pass. His shot is up off the back rim. No rebound to Van Kempen for Ohio, and they keep possession.
Another rebound for the Bobcats.
Bassett dribbling between his legs at the top of the key, guarded by Sherman. Comes off the screen. Bassett will hand off to Tommy Freeman. Back to Bassett on the far side. Bassett's been the best player on the floor so far. He's hit the 3-point. It's no good. But he was fouled as he went up. Mike McKee caught him on the elbow and Bassett to the line for 3 free throws.
Yeah, so they say,
I'm sorry, Joe, 2 shots. Apparently his foot was on the line.
Well, that's just a direct result of Armand Bassett realizing the one-on-one matchup he had against McKee, being able to take him off the dribble. This time he tried for a fadeaway, and McKee got the arm. Bassett earns it, goes to the line to shoot 2.
And that had changed their mind and given the 3 free throws. Bassett's first one is up and good. The officials kind of conferred and decided to give him the 3 shots. Washington set to check in for Ohio, and Henry Alla set to check back for Kent State. Second free throw good for Bassett.
Frank Henry Alla reporting
27-15 to score, 6:41 to go in the first half. Right now, Ohio shocking Kent State. And Kent State normally draws a crowd, and they do have a good crowd right behind us, Jordan. The crowd's been very quiet to start the game.
Aaron, you're going to be quiet when you're shooting 6 of 21 from the floor, 28%, 3 of 9 from the free throw line. That's 33%. They are being awful right now shooting the basketball. And, you know, credit to Ohio U. They're putting the ball in the hoop.
Bassett made all 3. McKee on the near side, 28-15 to score. Big lead for Ohio. It's 13. Sherman at the top of the key. Singletary checked back in at that last whistle for Kent State as well. They can't stand to have him on the bench. Henry Alla on the far side, holding the ball above his head, gets it to Green at the foul line, puts it on the floor, backs down Van Kempen, turning shot in the lane off the backboard, no good, ugly shot, the rebound pulled in by Bassett. Back comes Ohio, ball knocked away on the break, goes off of Singletary out of bounds, and it'll be Ohio basketball. 6:11 to go in the half, 28-15, 13-point advantage for the Bobcats.
And right now it's Armand Bassett. I mean, he's got 16 points. Aaron, he's averaging 15 on the season. He's got 16 in the first half.
Bassett inbounds pass to Freeman. Washington at the top of the key. Boy, Ohio's just on fire. They're making everything. Free throws, threes, doesn't matter. Sales has it on the far side. He'll try to drive on Singletary. Followaway jump is good. Everything going in for Ohio. Aswan Sales knocks it down. 30-15 to score.
Yeah, when a one-on-one move against the All-MAC Defensive Player of the Year goes in, you know it's going right.
Henry Alla on the near side, hands off to Singletary. They double-team him, holding the ball above his head. Henry Alla jumping from the top, in and out. No rebound pulled in by Van Kempen. Bodies flying all over the place. He's fastest, brings it back to the Bobcats. Gets in the lane now, pull it back up, and set up the offense. Nice feed in the lane, what a pick for a dunk! Bassett to Devon Washington for a throwdown. It's 32-15 Ohio with 5:26 to go in the first half. Timeout on the floor.
And a great recognition by Armand Bassett. They have the advantage. Chris Singletary tripped up in the backcourt. It was a 5-on-4 situation for Ohio U, and they found the open man for the flush.
Wow. 32-15, a 17-point lead, big lead for Ohio. At some point, Jordan, Kent State's going to have to find their defense and hope it leads to some scoring because the Bobcats are on an unbelievable run.
And again, this is all taking place with the freshman of the year, the starting point guard for Ohio U, DJ Cooper, out on the bench with 2 fouls. And quite coincidentally, the run started when those 2 fouls were picked up.
Bassett, to me, has been the best player on the floor, Jordan, by far. He's hitting everything and setting up his teammates. That feed to Washington was impressive. Kent State's got to try to stop the run. Henry Alla at the top of the key off to Sherman on the near side. Whistle and a foul called underneath is on Kenneth Van Kempen. Can't believe it.
Yeah, he was trying to run across and ran into Chris Singletary, who was setting a screen on the interior, and Van Kempen just ran over Singletary.
It's the 8th team foul on the Bobcats, so Kent State will shoot the 1-1.
And that's important, too, because that puts a second foul on Kenneth Van Kempen, so a substitution is going to be necessary for John Gross.
Evo Baltic will check in for Ohio, and Evans with that mohawk that Jordan described will check back for the Golden Flash.
And where is Tyree Evans right now? I mean, he led the team this year during regular season as three-pointers made. He's a double-digit scorer and really has not gotten into the flow thus far.
Number zero, Tyree Evans, not to be confused with Sacramento Kings rookie of the year candidate Tyree Evans. It's Tyree Evans. Free throw for Singletary's up and good as he's shooting the 1-1. Finally found his stroke from there after missing his first five. He's hit his next three.
I know Geno Ford is happy with having Tyree Evans, but imagine if he had Tyree Evans as well.
Kent State would be by far the number one seed. Simpson checks in for the Golden Flashes. Singletary's second free throw is up and good.
Well, Singletary knocked it down a couple from the charity stripe, but they need a stop right now because they're down 15 and we're getting the crucial portion of the first half.
32-17, Bobcats with the lead. Bassett with it at the top of the key, guarded all the way out there by Rodriguez Freeman. Hands off to Freeman. Freeman back to Bassett. Still guarded very tightly by Schultz. Comes off the pick. Gets it on the inside. Freeman open three-pointers. No good. The rebound pulled in by Shannon. They got the stop they needed. Back comes Rodriguez Freeman. Pulls up, thinks about a three, doesn't take it. Goes to Green at the top of the key to Singletary. Singletary dribbles to Green again. Green in the lane off the glass, no good. Gets his own rebound, but a whistle and a foul going to be called on Singletary pushing off on Tommy Freeman.
Tommy Freeman, a great job there. You can't be just in the knockdown threes. He did an excellent job boxing out his man before the effort got thrown to the floor. Foul called on Kent State.
32-17, Ohio with the lead. 4:37 to go in the half.
And this is a critical part. I mean, if you be a Kent State fan or you're at Kent State, you start to think about getting this lead down to 10, getting it down to 8 points so you can build some momentum for the second half.
Get within striking distance pass time, exactly. Massive dribbling to the far side, just trapped out there by Montelay, stolen by Green. Here comes Kent State on the break, Simpson in the forecourt, dribbles between his legs, back to Evans, open three-pointer, is in and no good. Offensive rebound pulled in by Green, ball knocked away from him, stolen by Bassett, but Green gets it back. Green passes Montelay, stolen again by Ohio. Bassett comes out of the pack with it, and he'll slow it up in the half court for it. The Bobcat defense has been swarming.
Right now, it just seems like they want it more. They're getting after every loose ball, every offensive rebound, every block shot is going Ohio's way.
John Gross wants a timeout. 32-17.
30 seconds.
Ohio with the lead. 3:59 to go in the first half. We'll keep it here. Boy, Jordan, it seems like every loose ball, every big defensive stop, they're making all the open shots. Evan missed the open three. It's funny. You'd think that Kent State would have been the team to have the good start because they're the more experienced club, but led by Bassett, it's been all Ohio here in the early going.
It has, and I'm really surprised by that. But here's the interesting thing, though. We've seen a little bit of different defense the last two possessions for Kent State. They've been trying to trap our man Bassett the moment he gets off into the half court. So let's see now if there's an adjustment now for the final 4 minutes for John Gross, maybe get the ball out of the hands of Armand Bassett, let someone else go to work.
Yeah, it's interesting. You know, I'm surprised they didn't try that earlier, Geno Ford and Kent State, because you know their point guard went to the bench, and Bassett's not used to handling the ball this much. He's done a wonderful job. Ohio inbounds underneath their own basket. Beautiful play, lob pass to Washington, who lays it in.
And I think that's a direct result of what you get out of a coach. If he could draw up a play in the half court to get an easy basket from a timeout, you know you've got a good one.
Sherman at the top of the key, off to McKee, back to Rodriguez. Sherman goes in the post to Green, backs down Washington, back to Sherman, open three-pointer, good for Rodriguez Sherman.
And that's a big three. I mean, again, Kent State renowned for knocking down some open threes as well, and if Sherman could get going, that's another compliment to Chris Singletary.
34-20, lead back to 14. Freeman's got it on the far side, it goes to Evo Baltic, feeds to Sales on the near side, to Washington, back to Sales, to Bassett at the top of the key. Bassett tries to drive, gets in the lane, but he runs up off the glass, and good. Armand Bassett doing it all.
That was off of his fingertips, folks, his fingertips, as he dribbled drive to the left side and lit it up with the left hand.
He's got 18 points in the first half. Half his team's first, 36-20. Bobcats with the lead. McKee feeds in the lane to Sherman. Head first, gets it back away from him, gets it back, the leader's up low, tapped in, go by Simpson.
Good job there by Kent State, going after the offensive rebound, getting an extra possession to cut this lead down to 14.
2:40 to go in the half. It's 36-22, Ohio with the lead. Back in the lane. Nice feed to Baltic. His layup is up. No good. He missed the bunny. Rebound to Green. Back comes Kent State. Randall Holt brings in the forecourt to set up the offense for the Golden Flash. Picked up by Green. Left-handed dribble for Holt. Gets it to McKee on the far side as he tries, gets in the lane where the runner is up off the glass, no. Loose ball picked up though by Green underneath, whistle.
No shot,
foul first on the floor is gonna be on Ohio. So Justin Green will go to the line to shoot one and one. When we come back, 2:13 to go in the first half. 36-22 Ohio with the lead. Green's free throws coming up. You're listening to the Mid-America Conference Tournament on ESPN 850 WKNR and ESPNCleveland.com. Congratulations, 2:13 to go in the first half at Quicken Loans Arena in downtown Cleveland. Aaron Goldhammer and Jordan Sherwood with you. Ohio with a 36-22 lead on Kent State. Jordan, I mean, at some point you figure the Bobcats might cool off and allow Kent State to make a run, but it has not happened so far in this first half. They're making everything.
They are making everything, and obviously it has to start with Armand Bassett since he took over the point guard responsibilities for Ohio U. He's got 18 points, he's got 4 assists, but I'm going to circle those 4 assists. Sure, he's getting into the scoring column, knocking out some threes, but being able to find your teammates, get them involved as well, it's that complementary piece that's going to help you advance in March, whereas we see with Kent State, who's the one guy they got going? It's Chris Singleton. No, there's Tyree Evans, there's Rocky Ken Sherman. None of these other guys are contributing, and that's why I think the Golden State Flashes are down this early in the ballgame.
Field goal shooting. Ohio shooting 56%, 14 of 25. Free throw for Green is up and good. Shooting the 1-1. Cuts the lead down to 13, 36-23. Kent State shooting 8 of 29. 27, 26%.
And 1 of 7 from 3. And 14 to 11. You can knock down Jeffrey from here. Both sides.
Green, Green's second free throw is good. It's back to a 12-point game. All this is Kent State still in it. 36-24, 2:05 to go. First half, Baltic with it, top of the key, flips it off to Bassett on the far side. Bassett trying to drive, get the lane, kicks it off the stairs on the other side. Back out to basketball, knocked away, stolen by Henry Allen. Here they come in the break, 2-on-2. Break Henry Allen pulls up, they'll hold it up in the half court. Sherman to McKee, top of the key, three-pointer, off the rim, no good. And the rebound pulled in by Bassett, they're 1-of-8 from three. Long pass ahead to Washington. Quick to dribble, gets it in the lane, water up and good for Navarro Washington.
What a little spin move and laid it up with the left hand. A beautiful one-on-one move by Washington.
He's got 6 points in all in impressive fashion. A dunk, a lob off an inbound play, and that's